Hello everyone, this is Derek with Reef Automation, and here we go with another fish video. This one is probably one of my favorites. As a child, I always wanted one, and after learning a bit about them, I realized that this is probably one of the most difficult animals to keep. So without further ado, let's get started. Okay, so the seahorse. So there's a number of different types of seahorses. There are large seahorses, there are small seahorses, there's even something called dwarf seahorses that are extremely small, but they're pretty much all the same in how you have to take care of them. I will say that when you are deciding to get a seahorse, you need to decide whether or not you're going to have a large enough tank for them. Generally speaking, if you get the dwarf seahorses, you can get away with quite a bit of them in a 5 or even a 10-gallon tank, but they're very small. They're probably less than a half of an inch, and they stay that way. If you're going to get one of the larger species, I would suggest a 30-gallon at least for these. And with seahorses, I always recommend that it is a species-only tank, and that you don't put these in reef tanks, that you don't put these in fish tanks. They move extremely slow, and they are extremely slow eaters, and therefore they're going to compete or be out-competed for food most of the time. They generally will not bug other fish. They will generally not bug other invertebrates. They will eat small feeder fish or small feeder shrimp. So generally you're going to want to have live feeders for these guys. Mysis, brine shrimp are fine. They can and have been adapted to frozen mysis, and that can be what you're going to need to feed them. Now generally speaking, seahorses should be fed 3 times a day. So it can be quite cumbersome and also pricey to keep seahorses because you have to feed them so often. Feeding them live feeders 3 times a day, housing them, so forth, can become quite expensive. So just be aware, if you are interested in getting seahorses, that you're going to be feeding them often. I've seen people feed them less and they just don't live as long, and they don't grow, and they don't have a happy life. So just be aware. So seahorses come in a lot of different colors. They come in yellows, reds, blacks. You can get them in all different sizes. I prefer to get a baby seahorse to start. Generally 2-3 seahorses will do just fine in a 30-gallon tall tank. If you want to do any more, again, if it's a tall tank, they should be fine. I don't generally recommend anything with them other than invertebrates, like snails will be fine, hermit crabs will be fine. You can keep them with corals. They generally do really well with gorgonians because they use their little tail to wrap around the gorgonian. So gorgonians are a good pick with seahorses. They do pretty well with most water quality. They actually do pretty well with dirty water quality. You're not going to really find many issues with housing seahorses. Obviously, I said they're a difficult species to keep because of essentially feeding them. That's going to be your most difficult to deal with them. And also, they're very slow. So competitive fish will not do good with seahorses. I always recommend people that are interested in seahorses to not have any fish with them other than slow-moving fish, such as pipefish, such as possibly smaller gobies that don't swim up to the top of the tank where the seahorse get fed. So hopefully you liked this video, and if you did, go ahead and hit the thumbs up. And if you haven't subscribed, we're going to have more of these. Again, just a basic introduction to the seahorses. And if you have any questions or comments, just leave them below. Thank you for watching, and I hope you have a wonderful day. Thank you.